Back and you're watching Commodity Champions, and we are discussing the state of agriculture, the year that has gone by, and what are the expectations really from the industry in the year coming by. Pankaj Agarwal of Just Organic as well now joins us. The government, of course, has had a lot of thrust on agriculture, but it also has been about organic farming, contract farming, food processing that the government has used as key buzzwords as well. Pankaj, thank you so much for joining us. My first question really is, what would you say about 2018? Has enough been done for the agriculture and in right direction?
Yeah, well, 2018 has been the year of changes. We have seen a lot of, ups and downs, specifically when we talk about the agriculture. The agriculture in general is basically the largest workforce employer, at the same time also contributing to almost 17-18% of the GDP. As I say that there is a niyat, niti and niyati. So niyat means intention, which has been very, very good starting from the new government that has come in, and a lot of reforms were being talked about. 2018 has really been the year of the policies that came in. We saw the budget going into the direction where they talked about a lot of agri entrepreneurs to come in, the farmer producer organizations to come in, the infrastructural reforms in the farm sector that were supposed to come in. So all those policies have been sort of implemented, framed in 2018, and we are now to see the execution of those policies coming out in the area where they actually start creating the impact, and we see these farmer protests and things like that going coming down. We have seen the biggest policy level reform, which is basically the change of the MSP. It has been implemented now, but again, from the execution perspective, whether that has actually resulted into any benefit to the farmers at all or not, that is yet to be seen. So I would say that 2018 has been more about the year to implement or to come out with the policies, and hence paving a way for the farm sector to go down to a path where it can actually reach to the bigger goal of 2022, doubling farmers' income.
So, Pankaj, what would you say, while there is a mention of the organic farming and exports in the policy, what is the market share really that we stand at right now?
We always say that 20% of world's population is consuming less than 0.2% of the world's organic produce. Why is so? So we look at the global phenomena, it is all about organic at this point in time. We talk about India, we are not consuming that much as we could have consumed. So the biggest challenge has been, a lot of talks, but not working on the consumption side. So it's always a supply and demand. You create demand, the supply will happen. So you talk about the consumption and talk about the ways and the means to increase the consumption, the supply will start happening. And if we then look at the supply side, all the problems that we are facing, I have myself interviewed a lot of farmers, I have interacted with a lot of farmers. There have been farmers who shifted, for example, from the conventional farming to the organic farming, and where they were actually distressed, they actually got into a situation where they are actually making money. So this could work out to be a self-sustaining, holistic model from the farmer's perspective and overall good for the nation. So far, the government's focus, specifically we talk about organic, has been more on the farming side, which is good, which should be done. But at the end of the day, if the farmers is not able to sell the produce, then they will eventually come back to the conventional practices, because they will at least get a better looking produce. So if the government starts working on the policies, the ways and the means to promote the organic food, it will ultimately result into the increase in demand, and finally the farmers get benefited. And I think this is something that has to be set in into the government and the policymakers' perspective, that the consumption side has to be increased.
What would you say, what is the sense right now? I mean, there is much desire, as you said, that we should be, the organic farming should be kept out of GST, there should be more export incentives, etc. How competitive are we in the markets right now?
So, again, India is a large producer, but when it comes to export, we are only exporting 2,500 crores kind of organic produce. which is sort of minuscule if we really look at the global scenario. Why is so? And out of that, also 50% is cotton and oilseed. So why is it so? It is because of the fact that, you know, again, it is little bit linked to the farm and our policies with the farm. We become non-competitive in many, many areas because, for example, the MSP has been increased for the farmer. Now, the MSP has been increased, and when it comes to the global marketplace, the increase in the MSP would not necessarily mean that we are competitive at that stage. So what do we do? As a country, we need to get into the value addition of the products. We need to get into more export incentives for the sector. At this point in time, the export of any agri produce is treated.
Pankaj, I get what you're saying. There's plenty that needs to be done, but it all boils down to the fact that how much market share does India really have in the organic market versus vis-a-vis other bigger international markets? What are those numbers?
So at this point in time, if we look at US, it's a $50 billion market for organic. We look at India, we are talking about maybe a couple of $100 million of market. So that's the big, big difference. And the population gap is, you know, 300 million versus 1.2 billion. In India, we consume a lot of ingredients, you know, which is basically the grains, the fresh and things like that. It is primarily about focusing on the consumer and educating the consumer about the safe food. If government puts focus, comes out, for example, the advertorials, the advertisements, and the marketing, like it was done for GST, that, you know, there is organic food, it is the safer food, and hence one could consume organic food. Not talking about any brand, not talking about anything else, it will increase the confidence of the consumer to go out and buy organic. Once they start doing that, the consumption could increase multifold, and the whole industry could actually see a very, very sharp rise. So in India right now, we are sitting at that inflection point that if right policies are put in, right marketing is done, and a environment of trust is created with the consumer, we could be looking at, you know, 3 to 5 times growth in next 2 to 3 years.
All right, Pankaj, look forward to that kind of a run-up. Thank you so much for joining us today. So it all boils down to those things, really, that it needs to be more competitive, the policies need to be implemented well, the value chain needs to be created, and of course, it is about ensuring that we do stand on the international map. The export incentives, of course, is yet another thing that both our guests spoke about today. Well, that's about the agriculture state in India and the expectations in 2019. And with that, it's a wrap-up on this edition of Commodity Champions. Thank you so much for watching.
A small town in Ahmedabad district that is shaping to become the growth engine of Gujarat, Dholera Special Investment Region. Watch the story unfold on Vibrant Gujarat, Episode 5, at this time, only on CNBC TV 18.
In association with Vibrant Gujarat, shaping a new India.
Alexa, play Lela Me Lela.
Okay.
Alexa, give me an applause.
Okay.
Amazon Echo. Just ask.
I'm Kiran Solanki, chartered accountant and a marathon runner. I was detected for type 2 diabetes 10 years back. After detecting for my type 2 diabetes, I decided to change my lifestyle. Now I am running marathons since last 10 years. My sugar levels are absolutely under control. By adopting a healthy lifestyle, by having proper food and doing regular walks, jogs and exercise, you can live an absolutely normal life.
Fortune Vivo and Network 18 present Make India Diabetes Free.
The Marana quota of emerging markets,
and now it seems as the government
is for Air India.
Mixed reaction.
Bombarded by news all day long. Separate the news from the noise with a 30-minute insight into the most important news stories of the day. What's hot? At these times, only on CNBC TV 18 and CNBC TV 18.com.
What's Hot? Brought to you by Hetic Fittings, German quality you can trust. And Kirloskar, enriching lives.